Last night, Donald Trump and Joe Biden squared off in their first presidential debate, and it was a disaster.
You graduated either the lowest or almost the lowest in your class. Don't ever use the word smart with me. The radical question, left.
Will you shut up, man? Listen. And by the way, maybe you could inject some bleach in your arm, and that would take care of it. This is the
that
same man.
That was said sarcastically, and you know that.
First of all, it was a disaster for presidential debates. We have never seen a presidential debate so messy, so disrespectful, so uncivil. We have never seen a sitting president interrupt and talk over and insult his opponent like we saw Donald Trump last night. He looked like a 10-year-old, and that's being very, very generous. It was also a disaster for the issues. In the midst of all the back and forth, in the midst of all the crosstalk, we didn't get an opportunity to actually hear much about the issues. The debate starts off with a conversation about the Supreme Court. And we don't get any justification for why Donald Trump is making the choice that he made, because the conversation quickly devolved into everything but the Supreme Court.
The bigger problem that you have is that you're going to extinguish 180 million people with their private health care that they're very
That's
happy
simply
with.
Not true.
Well, you're certainly going to socialist. You're going to socialist medicine.
We're now into open discussion.
Open discussion.
Open discussion. Yes, I agree.
We didn't get an opportunity to hear any plans for the future, any vision for how we can get out of the mess that we're in. We just had more and more old men yelling at each other. This was a disaster for the left. There was no left-wing conversation that happened in last night's debate. Donald Trump did everything he could to frame Joe Biden as an extreme radical. And so Joe Biden spent much of his time retreating from that position and saying, look, I don't support defunding the police. I don't support the Green New Deal. I don't support Medicare for all. And so they were fighting for the center and for the right so much that we didn't get to hear any progressive vision for America. Let me be clear. Joe Biden is a much better option than Donald Trump. You should vote for Joe Biden and not Donald Trump. I'm being clear about that. However, we didn't get any opportunity to articulate a vision. The debate was a disaster of journalism. Chris Wallace did everything that he could, to manage this debate. I don't blame Chris Wallace for what happened last night. What else could Chris Wallace do? You can't make Donald Trump be quiet. You can't pull a mic out. You can't scream, shut the fuck up. There's nothing you can do but let it ride.
That's the end of the segment. We're moving on.
It didn't take them.
Well, Vice President, no.
Can I be honest? It's a very important question.
Try to be honest.
No,
the answer to the question is no.
Ukraine.
No, sir.
With $1 billion, if you don't get rid of
the tax. You know what?
You're not true. You're doing it.
You're going to have.
True.
Gentlemen.
The journalism disaster that I'm talking about is after the debate. The headlines, the tweets, where people said this was a disrespectful battle between two people, or these two hurled insults and interrupted each other. This is not both sides. This is not each other. This was Donald Trump being a child and Joe Biden trying to stand there and have a debate. Now, Joe Biden wasn't perfect. There are moments where Joe Biden squandered opportunity. Joe Biden had an opportunity to explain what his vision for healthcare was, to try to explain why Medicare for all doesn't work. Joe Biden had an opportunity to push back when Donald Trump says, well, elections have consequences and I'm not president for 3 years, I'm president for 4 years, so I should be able to appoint a Supreme Court justice. Biden should have said, well, yeah, that's true. Obama was president for 4 years too, and it didn't stop Republicans from blocking Merrick Garland. He had an opportunity to show that we're not just voting for him because he's infinitely better than Trump, but because he has a legitimate vision for the future. He didn't do that. So this debate for me was a disaster of such proportion that I'm not sure I want to see another one. If they have it, I'll watch it. But we shouldn't have any more debates because we ain't learning anything from the debates. We're not getting any information. We're not getting any points of view. We're not getting any politics. We're just getting a reality show from two angry old white men. Hopefully, when Kamala hits the scene and Mike Pence hits the scene, we can have a real policy debate. We'll see.